We decided to do our video essay on one of the first true cinematic auteurs of the 21st century, Edgar Wright. Although his name isn't very recognizable outside the circle of filmic connoisseurship, Edgar Wright is responsible for writing and directing the very popular Cornetto trilogy, the instant cult classic Scott Pilgrim vs. the World, and the recently released critically acclaimed Baby Driver, which begs the question as to how a 43-year-old with 5 major directing credits can be hailed as one of the new millennium's first auteurs. Well, first, it's hard to imagine any of Edgar Wright's films without the quick and witty writing that forever encompasses the characters in said world. Whatever is being said is usually reinforced by quick visuals, whip pans, crazy transitions, and strong visual comedy that keeps us as the audience on our toes and helps us better navigate through that world. And Edgar Wright is a master of bending genres to fit the scope of the world that he's trying to evoke. Whether it's horror, sci-fi, or straight-up guns-a-blazing action thrillers, Edgar Wright's writing is ever-present in the characters that he writes, and how well he fleshes them out. As seen in this video where he and Simon Pegg, co-writer and frequently used lead in the Cornetto trilogy, explain the process that goes into making characters, creating places, and geographically mapping a town for Hot Fuzz, so much is in detail and given about these places and people in order for the people to be more visually palpable, and their existence relative to the town as a whole. Although Edgar Wright does frequently reuse Simon Pegg and Nick Frost for the Cornetto trilogy, Wright is careful about how he writes both of their characters, and usually gives them interesting dynamics so as to not be making the same movie 3 times with just different villains and the same fence gags. And speaking of gags, it's Edgar Wright's strong stylistic choice of visual comedy through camera gags and pans that also draws us to his films. Whereas some directors might go through the trouble of over-explaining or overshooting, it's hard to say that it's not fun to watch Wright's modern montages of ordinary daily life, or how quickly you can plan a rescue party for your ex-girlfriend, mom, and zombie stepdad. Lastly, and possibly the most important in recent films, is his musical alignment between cinema and soundtrack. While most ordinary directors would plaster a classic jam and have the cast just do cool shit while everything around them just happens a la Suicide shit, Wright carefully times the sound of the film with the sound of the music. Whether it's footsteps, intense stares, laying money down, or beating the shit out of a recently deceased man with pool cues, what this gives you is more noticeable visual cues and a way to navigate through a scene easier. It gives the film Baby Driver a singular stylistic flair that is unique and refreshing and can be used to cue the audience, whether it's a tense moment, a happy one, or a moment where everything has gone to shit. It should go without saying that Edgar Wright is not singularly responsible for all the things that make his films great, but his role at the helm is what helps differentiate an Edgar Wright film from Ant-Man written by Paul Rudd or The Adventures of Tintin, films that Wright helped write but didn't direct, ultimately showing that Wright's quick time editing, eclectic soundtracks, visual comedy, and homage are what helps solidify him as a true cinematic auteur. Also, Queen is awesome, and Edgar Wright knows it.